I do with my black family than I do with my white family.
Yeah, go get it. Grand cocktail.
Do you think, I've had recently had this conversation too, you know, sometimes with black women or darker skinned black women, when they get upset or feel like they want to express themselves in a passionate way, it's they're aggressive, they mean, they angry. And I feel like when I've seen Hispanic women do that, even though it's a different culture, I feel like their skin is lighter or on that light skin scale, they're spicy.
Since I am kind of racially ambiguous, people just tend to kind of be like, oh yeah, that's spicy, that's, you know, that is exotic. Like, you know, that makes me maybe look a little bit more interesting to some people.
I see myself on the color spectrum as a mocha brown. A lot of people say, you know, a pecan tan, but I feel like I can be a mocha brown at times until I get some Caribbean beaches, you know, then I get a little darkened, which I love. That's when you get to that exotic, you know, cocoa.
I am considered a caramel brown skin girl amongst my friends and my family, but, and I would see you as a perfect pretty vanilla, but other people will use them in an ugly tone, and it depends on who it's coming from, I guess.
Because there is a difference, like, you know, there's certain foods that we like more than other foods. Like, I feel like, you know, chocolate is, you know, obvious, often associated with really delicious things, and, you know, elegance and all that. And then, you know, you call somebody waffle color. I mean, I feel like the first thing you think about is ego.
Like, you look at me as edible. Yes, I'm food. I'm delicious. And I agree, the darker the berry, the sweeter the juice. That's a compliment to me, I think. Yeah, like, guys, get the sweeter I get, sweeter the darker I get. Hey, I'm fine with that. So I don't take it as offensive. I personally might take it as, hey, okay, you look at me as edible. That's right.
If a white person says it, I may, or a white person or anyone that's not black, I may take that a little bit differently, because I'm not sure how I feel about a white person being like, oh, well, chocolate drop, you know, or vanilla bean. I'm like,
We wouldn't necessarily look at each other as enemies in regards to shades of color, or even try to depict what shade we are if it wasn't for white people.
The world, it will end, no, because people are living in ignorance, and they choose to live in ignorance, and they don't want to understand. So no, I don't think it will change.
I do not think that the white community recognizes or understands colorism at all, because it's impossible. From my opinion, I think that it's impossible for them to understand colorism, not just colorism, but anything that has to do with the black community, because you can try your best to understand even someone that's white that grew up in a predominantly black community. You see the things, but you just cannot fully understand colorism, what we go through. You just can't. It's impossible.
To me, like, when, you know, being half white, half black, like, the way they refer to colorism or somebody being a darker shade is by being tan. It has nothing to do with, like, anything else other than maybe you was just sat out in the sun. Like, now you got this nice color. Like, they, white people want to be tan. They want that. So, like, they don't see it as something to divide. They see it as more of like, oh, you got something that, like, I'm trying to get that. Otherwise, I'm gonna be red. Like, I don't think they see it so much as, like, such a division. But again, there's that whole ignorance feeling of, like, they don't know the pain that's associated with it.
Well, to me, colorism is something within your own community, right? So you have colorism in India, you have colorism in Asia, and I'm talking about it in the black community. That's what provoked me to do this book. So is it because we're keeping it up? Because to me, that don't have nothing to do with the white man. I know it came from that. Like you said, you separate things out. But we have a choice to
keep
it going or not. You know what I mean? So,
you know, people crack jokes and try to jump on and all that other stuff. I try to remove myself from that because the number one thing that people will bring up is how dark my skin is. And that was like a very sensitive subject.
But we actually had the conversation about colorism with my daughter. She has like 7 classmates, and she came home and said, "Well, my teacher is pink." And I was like, "Okay, what do you mean she's pink? Her teacher's just a fair-skinned lady." And she's like, "Well, Cole could be as good looking as me if he looked more like me. Cole's just a little bit darker." And I said to her, "Well, I don't think you should look at their color. I think you should look at their spirit."
For my skin color. Growing up, I definitely used to buy my friends, let them hold my clothes, you know, bring certain stuff to them, buy certain stuff for them. Naturally, wouldn't nobody, you know, no one would come up and just talk to me, you know. I was picked on a lot growing up. One particular time, I lent a girl my clothes, and my mom actually like drove us home from school. She picked us up from school, and she went to drop us off, but she didn't say nothing to me when we were in the car. But when she got out, she could not believe this girl had on my brand new outfit that I never wore before. But she was just like, you know, you gotta stop buying your friends. Either they're gonna like you or they're not, you know. Colors, like I thought I couldn't wear certain colors. Lipsticks, thought I couldn't wear certain lipstick.
It was something on YouTube or something, and he mentioned something about that, like mixed kids are the best looking babies. You know, he said he felt strongly about it, and it's like, okay. I mean, that's your preference or opinion or whatnot, but what does it really say? And what happens to those men? I know men like that, and they have a dark-skinned daughter. And if that's truly your views, then what? You can't even tell your daughter she's beautiful because you don't believe it.
Yeah, and I do. I do have a dark-skinned daughter, a darker tone.
It wasn't until I was like in the 4th grade when I like realized, okay, there is a difference. Like, there is a difference with the way that people look at me and or the way that black people are even looked at. So it definitely is disrespectful just because it feels like, okay, someone is questioning if I can even understand their struggle just because I am a little lighter.
I've never actually been told that I wasn't black enough in terms of like my skin, but I've been told I wasn't black enough in terms of how I act. So like, oh, you act like a white girl, you talk like a white girl. Last I checked, I have melanin, okay? Just because I speak a different way than you doesn't mean I'm not black. If anything, it's just I'm different. I grew up differently, and that doesn't make me any different from anyone else.
I feel like someone light skin is acting entitled or privileged. I have said, because she light skin. Like, I have felt that way, like, because growing up, it's been a thing. It's like, it seemed like they've always got what they want. It seemed like it's like a spoiled type thing. And so when I feel like you're acting that way, I'm like, oh, it's probably because they light skin. So, I mean, is that disrespectful?
It's been hurtful sometimes to hear people say those kind of things, because it's just like, it puts you in a box, like, maybe I just am spoiled because I'm spoiled. Like, it's not necessarily because of the color of my skin, maybe it's just because I was raised to have finer things or something, you know?
Absolutely.
But, yeah, no, definitely, like, I feel like it's something that you gotta give, like, the Jada eye roll. Like, every time, like, you hear that type of joke, like, you just be like, well, I'm light skinned, but it feels like when people make those type of jokes, it's really hard to, like, turn around and try to make another one back at somebody else's expense.
I've ever really been placed in a situation where I was like, oh, it's me against this dark-skinned girl. I know I got it. No, that situation's never occurred, but I know for a fact that I hold that privilege in my skin.
I remember reading something that said like 20, 30 years from now, pretty much everyone is gonna be like mixed. They're gonna have not necessarily a lighter tone, but everyone's gonna be like a brown. It's gonna be rare to meet someone as beautiful as skin tone as you. It's gonna be very rare 30 years from now. So I don't know if that's necessarily overcoming it, but I guess it would help?
Use another woman's skin tone to disrespect her as retaliation. Because I was told as a child by my niece and by my aunt, I have an older niece, I know it's weird, that, you know, I'm a purebred and light-skinned people are mutts. So I called another light-skinned girl a mutt when she told me I was black.
Very sensitive situation. Evolved, of course, you know, college stuff, had a little boo, caught her with my boo. So it was some words that came out of my mouth that probably, of course, looking back now, that was rude to say to another black woman, because looking back, she was a very beautiful woman. To this day, she's still a very beautiful girl. What I said, it didn't. And I said, I don't even want to reiterate what I said, to be honest, because it was just that disgusting. But it was out of hate. It was out of just anger.
Do you think it was because it stemmed from, like, some intimidation, or do you feel like you used it to try to hurt her?
I'm actually glad you said that, because looking back, I think it was a little bit intimidation, because honestly, she was a gorgeous girl. Gorgeous girl. So the only thing I could say about you that I felt like, you know, would cut deep was, you know, something about, you know.
And I think a lot of people do that too, especially in situations where you feel like you're trying to win an argument or disagreement. You kind of throw out things that you think would try to really hurt them, stuff that people may be sensitive about. So I definitely understand that. I know for me, I don't specifically remember ever trying to undermine somebody for their skin tone, because I'm dark myself, so it's I felt like it was nothing that I could really say.
When you used to see a light-skinned person, do you feel like, I ain't gonna F with you because you should know this and you're too close to white? Like,
do you give them a chance?
Oh, that's my question.
Everybody is one type to me, meaning love, until you do something to me. And like I said, my experiences come from that. It just isn't rooted in anger. It comes from, I haven't had a good experience with a fair-skinned woman, ever. Except that first, be black. Mm-hmm. You are mixed, but you're black.
Right.
I'm black. You're black. You're mixed, but you're black.
I'm not mixed.
Oh, you're black?
Both my parents are black.
Yeah. So. Oh, well, hey.
I'm just fair.
Fair-skinned, right. Black woman.
But I have to be, I do still like lighter women. The girl I'm dating right now, and I really feel like we're gonna do something. I really feel strongly about her. You saw a picture on Instagram.
Oh yeah, yes, cute.
She, oh man, she's everything to me. It's not cause she's light skinned. She has everything else, but I cannot deny it, that lighter complexion. I just feel like it goes with me.
And you like what you like, and you know what? And when you go, when it comes to dating and stuff like that, go ahead and get what you like in house, so you don't go looking for it.
Right, yeah, that's true.
Go ahead and get it. You like green eyes and all that, go ahead and put that in your house so you don't have to worry about cheating, stepping out. Mm-hmm. Get what you want inside.
Just get a better sense of where, you know, that whole dark skin versus light skin comes from. Why these beautiful, beautiful melanated women have felt like so, I don't even know, like trapped by their skin. Like, I can't even understand that. And that just kind of showed me even more like, that is some of my light skin privilege. Like, I haven't had to go through something like that. So I couldn't even imagine somebody calling me a terrible name and not fighting them right after. But I feel like it just also showed me that you do have to take the time to care about the people around you and listen and understand, like, just because you're not going through it doesn't mean that they're not going through it.
Love to be in the sun. Honestly, love to tan. If I can get darker, I would. Truth be told, weirdly enough, I'm at a place I kind of wish I was a little darker and had a little more melanin.
Yeah, I love all black people, all colors, but yes, I get caught up into the sometimes.
Yeah,
too.
It happens, but that I feel like that's the point of this project, to bring it to the forefront. And then you can choose to do something about it or not. Sometimes people do stuff subconsciously. They're not even aware of what they think or what they believe. And the point is to try to get to the, I feel like it's gonna start with children. I think once people in our age group and stuff, if we can get our children to realize that ain't it, you know, you don't treat people a certain type of way based on their complexion, you can have a preference. I feel like there's nothing wrong with that. But when you treat somebody a certain type of way, I only say only this is beautiful because of the color of it. I don't rock with that. And I just hope that children will start.
think I want you anymore. So I only, and I want you to be my one and all, my one and only. So I want it, and I want you to be my one.